Hi guys, Nick Jennison with Guitar Interactive. Today, we are down at the Laney factory checking out two new heads from the Ironheart IRF range. This is the IRF lead top, and this is the IRF dual top, and they're both members of the same family as the fantastically popular IRF loud pedal. Now, they basically contain the same tone generating circuitry and the same 60 watt power amp. So these will give you 60 full watts of solid state power, but they have the same amazing sounding gain structure that we have in this pedal. The only real difference between the two, between the dual and the lead, is the feature set. Now, in the intro, you heard us playing through some of the sounds in the dual. Let's just switch over to the lead and we'll do some more sounds, and then we'll come back and talk about the spec for both of these amps. Now we've got a chance to hear a smattering of the tones that these amps can produce. Let's talk about the spec, starting with the lead top. Now, the lead top is the simplest and smallest of the pair, has two channels, which are clean and lead, which are foot switchable, but also accessible with this switch here. We have a switchable boost, which you can use to get some breakup out of the clean channel, or you can use to take the lead channel completely over the top into screaming high gain territory. We have a three band cut boost EQ. That's very, very important. So at 12 o'clock, things are kind of pretty well set for a nice all-round sound, but you can cut and boost the low end or the middle or the high, which is a little different to the way EQ works on most passive tone stacks, which are cut only. Either way, it sounds fantastic at 12 o'clock, but there are lots of tone shaping possibilities too. If we go to the lead channel, we have this switch over here, which gives us lead bright, flat, or dark. And this, to my ear at least, similar to this and similar to the loud pedal, is coming before the distortion. So it's kind of a response shaping tool. If you go to bright, it's gonna make things more aggressive and more articulate, but it's not gonna introduce a ton of extra treble after the distortion. You will hear the amp brighten up, but it's more like kind of pushing the front end, I guess, with a bright distortion pedal, if that makes any sense. By contrast, dark is gonna fatten things up, make it really big and thick and smooth. This is great for kind of like tailoring the sound of the amp or the response of the amp to the particular guitar that you're playing, which is really nice. And of course, we can stack the boost on top. So before we go any further, let's take a listen to some of the sounds that the lead top has to offer, starting with a tour of the clean channel. Thank you. Next up, let's switch over to the lead channel and take a listen to the kind of sounds that we can get out of this channel. Now, before we move on to some sounds from the dual top, let's talk about one feature that's common to both amps. So both amplifiers give you 60 watts of power, which is more than enough to gig and rehearse with, but you can also use these as desktop platforms if you want to play quietly at home. And as such, there is a power reduction switch that takes you all the way from 60 watts down to less than 1 watt. Let's explore how that sounds with the lead top. Next up, let's talk about the dual top. And while it looks physically larger than the lead top, it's no louder. They're both 60 watts switchable down to less than 1 watt. But what it does have is more features. Specifically, you might think about this as having all of the sonic features of the loud pedal just built into the front of an amplifier. So we have two channels. Channel two is the dedicated gain channel, which has a big range of gain from like classic British 70s breakup through to over the top saturation, especially when we throw the boost on top. But we also have that same bright, flat, and dark switch, which has that same tone shaping and response shaping kind of functionality that we got out of the loud pedal and also out of the same switch on the lead top. But what it also has is it has reverb and it has a built-in XLR cab simulation with two cab modes, specifically a 412 and a 112, but you can also defeat that and use it without the cab emulation if you want to record with this and use your own IRs after the fact. So let's take a listen to some tones. We're going to start with channel two, which is the dedicated gain channel. Let's take a listen to that now. And next up, let's take a listen to channel one, which covers everything from clean sounds all the way through to mid-pushed vocal high gain lead tones. This is really powerful because it means you can set this up as kind of like a clean crunch setup or a clean high gain setup, or even a rhythm lead setup with channel one being the lead channel. Let's take a listen to some of the tones we can get out of channel one now. Next up, let's explore the cab emulation on the Dual. Now here, we have two options. We can either have a 412, a 112, or we can bypass it entirely. We're gonna go to gain two because distortion sounds tend to show up the character of cab sims a little better than clean sounds. Let's start with the 412. We'll switch it to the 112. We'll bypass it, which is gonna sound fizzy and horrible, but that's okay because that's what a bypassed cab sim is supposed to sound like. You would then feed that into your own IRs. Then we'll go back to the 112 and back to the 412 to finish. So there you go, guys. That's been a look at the new Laney IRF lead and dual tops. They're essentially loud pedals, but in amp format. They're incredibly versatile tonally and in terms of application, because you can either gig or rehearse with them, or you can switch them down to bedroom volumes and get these killer tones. You can record with them, especially the dual top with that XLR output, and the onboard reverb is a very, very nice addition. They're also incredibly light, come with specially designed speaker cabinets for each, and here's the kicker, they're really, really affordable. So if you want amazing tones that you can gig with, you can use it as a backup amplifier or even as your main amplifier, I could certainly see myself gigging one of these. It's more than loud enough to play pretty much any stage that you're likely to find yourself on. They're incredibly light, super, super portable, really, really versatile. You can use them on your desktop. You can fly with them if you so desire. Very little not to love here. These are really impressive amps from our friends at Laney. And like we said, super, super affordable. Once again, this is the Ironheart IRF lead top and dual top. My name is Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive. See you next time.